In this lesson, we'll be taking a look at Final Cut Pro 10.3's redesigned project timeline, what Apple refers to as Timeline 2.
This is probably Final Cut Pro's biggest new feature, and it's incredibly useful.
Let's start with the Timeline Index because it's unique to Final Cut Pro 10, and it's been greatly enhanced. For one, you're now able to search for compound clips and synchronize clips. I'll enter sync, and all my synchronized clips are returned by the search, and can be selected for applying effects, adjusting audio levels, or any number of editing operations. There's a redesigned roles pane, making it even easier to organize your audio into related content. For those of you unfamiliar with roles, they're nothing more than pre-assigned text labels that defines what a particular clip is, so it can be organized and tracked throughout the entire editing process. If you look at this timeline, you can see that some music clips appear with effects, and some effects appear with the dialogue. Final Cut Pro now gives you the ability to organize the timeline by placing all audio clips into designated lanes defined by its assigned role. By clicking the Show Audio Lanes button, all dialogue, music, and effects clips magically, or I should say magnetically, flows into its designated lane and is identified by the role's text label in the header of each lane. If your dialogue has overlapping audio, often called a split edit, it appears in the lower part of the lane. Typically, however, when you're doing sound editing, you'll be working on one part of your soundtrack at a time. For instance, you might want to work on just the sound effects or just the dialogue. The circular button at the far end of each roll will bring focus to that particular roll. Click the focus button for effects, and the dialogue and music rolls will be minimized in the timeline. Click the focus button for dialogue, and the effects and music rolls will be minimized. In each case, the audio rolls you're not working with are kept out of your way. But here's something even cooler. When a roll has been minimized, the individual clips can still be trimmed, and they can be selected for repositioning or for making volume and other changes in the audio inspector. Each of the roles can be rearranged in the timeline. So for instance, if you wanted to have all your sound effects appear closer to the primary storyline, simply drag upward on the roll until you see a blue insertion line appear above the dialogue roll, then release your mouse. The lanes rearrange themselves in the timeline. Now focus the effects roll, and the dialogue and music rolls become minimized in their new locations. Let's move the effects roll back to where it was, then focus the dialogue, because this is where you'll do most of your audio work initially. By clicking the Show or Clap subroll button, you can reveal the individual audio channels within each clip, what Final Cut Pro calls components. You can use the terms audio components and audio channels interchangeably. An audio component is the physical channel within each clip, and a subroll is the pre-assigned text label for that component. Here we see two subroll lanes, a Dialogue 1 lane and a Dialogue 2 lane. Some of the audio for this project resides in Dialogue 1, and some of it resides in Dialogue 2. Depending on what you need to work on, subroll priority can be changed. I'll drag Dialogue 1 above Dialogue 2. The lanes rearrange themselves in order to place the audio where you want it, in this case, closer to the primary storyline. If you look at each audio clip, some of them have badges in the upper left of the audio, indicating that you're looking at the individual component of a clip. Components give you an unbelievably efficient way to sweeten your audio. For example, I can apply an audio effect like this channel EQ to one of my dialogue components. Adjust the settings in the inspector, then copy the settings and paste those EQ settings to the other dialogue components in the lane. You can also quickly copy and paste components. I'll select a few of these sound effects, press Command C to copy them, move the playhead later in the timeline, and press Command V to paste. It's also very easy to reassign your audio to another lane. Let's turn off the focus for effects. Perhaps this particular clip was improperly assigned an effect role by the editor and should appear with the music. No problem. I'll just right-click on the clip and choose Assign Audio Roles. Then I'll choose the music subroll from the menu. The clip magnetically moves into the music lane because it's been tagged with new role metadata. Timeline 2 gives you some incredibly powerful ways to work with your audio, even while playing back. I'm going to go ahead and press the space bar, and as my project plays, I'm going to move the music lane to the top. The light transmissions of each lens, you can check it out.
An expensive lens will not make you a better filmmaker.
No, but it'll make me look like a better filmmaker. Then I'll click on the checkboxes for dialogue and effects to mute the sound for the other audio lanes so I can focus on just the music. Consider a scene like this. The entire audio editing experience seems so much more fluid now.
I agree. I love the color coding of the roles and the labeling of them. You look at your timeline and you can tell exactly what's going on. The ability to put everything into lanes when you want to, the ability to expand components when you want to organize them and reorganize them easily, and to be able to focus and collapse everything down makes it so easy to look at just what you want to look at and have it be exactly where you want it to be.
Absolutely. If you like this information, we've also produced an in-depth tutorial that covers even more ground, explores additional features, and explains key benefits and things to watch out for.
In the next lesson, we'll look at how roles get assigned in the first place.